displayed up on the screen. Who can read the standard? I want you to read just the standard. Tatiana.
Construct viable arguments and critique the reasoning of others.
All right, good. So let's look at that. Construct viable arguments and critique the reasoning of others. So this standard is telling me, what am I going to have to do or be able to do to demonstrate that I understand how to use mathematical practice 3? And we're going to look at it a little bit closer. That's just the standard. Now here is our mathematician friend. What is she saying here?
So in order for kids to be able to be successful at the content standards, they need the mathematical practice standards because the two standards work in tandem. The mathematical practices teach kids how to work and think like a mathematician, so it makes accessing the content standards a lot easier.
Now, mathematicians that are using mathematical practice 3, they have some thinking habits that help them. What are some thinking habits of a mathematician who's using mathematical practice 3? Cordell.
So today was the first exposure that the kids had to SMP 3. We've worked on SMP 1 and 6 prior to this, so they do have some understanding about what the mathematical practices are, but this was the first time they saw this one. That direct instruction is really important because you need to break that standard down so kids understand exactly what they are expected to be able to do to show that they have mastery of that standard later.
All right, so let's kind of break that down a little bit. I can explain my thinking. If I am constructing a viable argument, that's what I'm doing, right? I am explaining my thinking to others and respond to the mathematical thinking of others. That's the same as critiquing the reasoning of others, right? If I'm going to respond to someone else's mathematical thinking, I'm going to critique them or give them some feedback. Turn and face your face partner, please. Take just about a minute to talk to each other and explain if you know what it means to construct a viable argument and what it means to critique the reasoning of others. Lean forward and talk to your face partner.
So in the beginning for this first lesson, my role as the teacher is really just to kind of continue to repeatedly break down that standard and keep going back to what does the standard actually say. So the first lesson is really my instruction and I'm leading everything to make sure that they understand what the standard's actually asking them to do.
Melanie, can you read us the problem very quickly, please?
There are 3 rows of pictures on the wall. Each row has 6 pictures. How many pictures are on the wall?
So as soon as I read that, I'm thinking to myself, definitely sounds low level.
When you're choosing problems to practice the standards, you really want to look at problems that actually lend themselves to whatever that standard is. So I want to choose problems that are really going to give kids opportunities to explain their mathematical thinking. So I want to make sure they're challenging enough that gives them an opportunity to do that. And then also so that when they're giving feedback and critiquing each other, it needs to be a problem that actually lends itself to that, not something that's super straightforward, but that really lends itself to those mathematical conversations.
When I say go, all I want you to do is begin solving. You're going to work in shoulder partners. And as I'm coming around, I'm really just going to be listening to see if I hear any of that mathematical language that's going to let me know you're constructing viable arguments or critiquing the reasoning of others.
I think the part about constructing viable arguments, explaining their own thinking, they're pretty good at. But when it comes to critiquing others and asking the questions, they need a lot of practice with what kind of questions am I going to ask.
So Haley's going to model really quickly a little bit about how their conversation went. And when I was listening to them, I could tell, I think they're beginning to understand what SMP 3 says. So let's give them our attention.
I think we should do an array of 3 rows and 6 in each row.
Okay, so Jocelyn, Haley is making a what?
Plan.
A plan. I want you to give Haley some feedback or critique her reasoning. I want you to let Haley know what you think about her mathematical reasoning.
I think that plan's a good plan because then after we could do the array and after that we could use multiplication to figure out the answer.
Okay, eyes on me. So let's think about what we just saw. Standard 3.
Construct valuable arguments and critique the reasoning of others.
All right, standard 3 is the standard that we're going to be focusing on today. So if you could open up the first window there for math practice 3. All right, standard 3 says construct viable arguments and critique the reasoning of others. Tatiana, what does the mathematician say?
Mathematician says I can explain my thinking in response to mathematical thinking of others.
Okay, again, that will be the expectation today. I can explain my thinking and respond to the mathematical thinking of others. I can explain my strategy using Andrew.
At this point in the phase, I'm still reviewing the mathematical practice that I want them to focus on that day before I give them the problem. So we go over what are the expectations of that standard and how are they going to demonstrate their understanding of that standard. I review that with them and then I present them with the problem.
Lewis, read me the solve and share problem, please.
The solve and share problem says 24 divided by 4 is on the right side of the balance. Below, what can you write on the left side that will have the same value as the right side? Write 5 different multiplication or division problems that will keep the pens balanced.
All right, 24 divided by 4 is on the right side of the balance below.
Today I had them work in pairs collaboratively on the problem. My role while students were sharing with their partner was to ask some guiding questions that would push their thinking and their conversation towards the expectations of that standard. So I'm asking very targeted questions that I kind of have with me that I carry around that are going to elicit the kind of discussions that I want the students to be having with each other. Lewis, tell Haley why you did that.
I did that to check the problem and I did the inverse of multiplication.
Okay, so that if I start with a division equation and I check with a multiplication equation, Lewis just said you're using the what?
Inverse.
You're using the inverse operation, okay? So talk to me using a little bit of math vocabulary in your explanation. Start with the division equation.
Okay.
So I carry a clipboard with me that has a square that's numbered for each student in the class. And then as I'm going around and facilitating and listening in on the groups, I'm taking notes to myself about who's showing mastery, who isn't, maybe who's going to need to be pulled to a small group or have some reteaching. And then the wheel on the clipboard has those guiding questions just to remind myself what are the types of questions that I want to ask that are connected to the SMP for that day.
Can you explain that equation to me using math vocabulary?
The 6 is a factor, this 6 is a factor, and the 36 is the product.
Okay, so Lewis, Haley said 6 and 6 are the two factors in that problem, and 36 is the product. Do you agree or disagree with Haley?
So after they finished sharing and working together in pairs, I called on specific students to share their solution, and then I called on other students to give them feedback, because part of that standard is to be able to critique the reasoning of others. And so I wanted, once one student shared their solution, I wanted another student to critique their reasoning and then let them know whether they agreed or disagreed with the solution that the student gave.
Vladimir, explain your and Michael's equation using math vocabulary.
I do try to connect other SMPs that they have learned. So far students have learned SMP 1, 6, 2, and 3. So today when students were sharing their answers and giving feedback to other students, I was really pressing for them to use math vocabulary in their responses.
The 121 is the dividend, the 11 is the divisor, and the quotient is the 11 is the quotient.
Okay, Anna Marie, do you agree or disagree with Vladimir?
Vladimir, I agree with your math vocabulary. Because 121 is the dividend, 11 is the divisor, and 11 is the quotient.
Okay, now tell Vladimir whether or not you agree with his calculation.
And I also agree with your calculation because, if you do the inverse, like 11 times 11 is, it would be 21.
11 times 11 will equal what?
121.
So I had them share in a variety of ways because I wanted them to have more opportunities to work on explaining their mathematical thinking and being able to critique the reasoning of others. So after we did kind of a whole group share out, I had them pair up with someone who was not working at their table, so with someone else in the room. And then they had a card that had sentence stems on that that would, they would fill in their mathematical thinking, but it was connected right back to the standards. So it's helping them work towards being able to do that independently.
When I started working, I could tell my strategy was working because if I checked my multiplication table, all my answers were right.